She might have family somewhere.
So it was O'Driscoll's you ran into there?
Yeah. Last thing we was expecting.
What is it with the O'Driscoll's?
You ain't dealt with them? I suppose. Hell, we ain't run into them much the last 6 months. I guess because they've been over this way.
Nah. I've heard a lot of talk about them.
Well, we've been scrapping over scores with them for years. Big gang. Nasty sons of bitches. Their leader, Combe, and Dutch go way back. And not in a good way. A proper blood feud.
So I heard.
Watch out. Bear up ahead. Let's see if we can find another way around.
You must be real hungry. Stay well back. Spring storms like this are the worst for animals that sleep all winter.
He's got a lot of meat on him.
We've got enough here. No need to push our luck.
Cut up here, off the trail.
Easy now. Whoa, boy, easy now.
Yeah, okay, boy.
We ain't ever talked that much, you and me. How long you been with us now? 5-6 months?
Something like that.
Bet you didn't expect this.
What?
Any of this. Blackwater mess. Being up here?
Sooner or later, a job's gonna go wrong. Nature of life.
I just thought you might have moved on by now.
You want me to move on?
No. No, not at all. I just know you could run it alone, no problem.
I did that for a long time. I'm done with it. Always wondering if someone's gonna kill you in your sleep.
I still wonder that most nights.
I reckon you're okay. This suits me. Sure, I could fall in with another gang, but Dutch. You know, Dutch is different.
Oh, yes. Dutch is certainly different.
He treats me fair. Most of you do. And for a fellow with a black father and an Indian mother, that ain't normally the case.
Well, we need you now. More than ever.
Good. And how long have you been with these boys? Why ain't you run off?
Me? Oh, 20 years, something like that. Since I was a boy.
20 years?
Yeah. Taught me to read. John, too. Tell me a few other things, him and Hosea.
Huh. I'm sure.
Dutch saved me. Saved most of us. That's why we need to stick by him through this. He always sees us right.
How's that new horse?
He's all right. He'll do for now. I appreciate you letting me take Taima the other night.
She's a strong one. It's been as hard on the horses as on the rest of us. I don't know what Dutch would do if something happened to the Count.
Same with Bill and Brown Jack. He's a drunk, miserable bastard, but he loves that horse.
I hope they all make it.
I tried to ride the Count once. Fuck me faster than a bull. Won't take nobody but him.
Time over here.
Brought some food back, boys.
Watch out!
Oh, watch it.
Come on, let's get these over to Pearson.
And thank you for showing me how to use the bow properly.
I only showed you a little. It takes a lifetime of practice to master.
What a surprise. Find a camp rat loitering around in the kitchen.
Is that any way to greet an old friend? I feel like we haven't spoken for days.
I do my utmost to avoid you.
He loves me, really. It's his sad way of showing affection.
No, it isn't. Now shoot, get lost.
Well, see you gents later.
See, you got on just fine.
Charles is a wonder.
Have a drink, boys. You earned it.
Jesus, what is that?
Navy rum, sir. It's the only thing. The only thing. Keeps you sane, it does.
Yes. Oh. Seems to have done a treat on you. You go rest that hand, Charles.
I'll be fine in a few days.
You mind helping me with the skinning, Mr. Morgan? It's easier if we do it together.
Do I get to skin you?
You're always one with the jokes, aren't you? Come on.
This really isn't a job for a man with a burnt hand. I'll see you both later.
You skin that one that you dumped on the floor there. Not too bad, Mr. Morgan. Yeah. They always said you were a butcher. You know, you could trade these or sell these in pretty much any town. If you're looking to make a legitimate bit of money, of course.
Right now, I'm just looking to get off this mountain alive.
Well, if you catch anything else, you bring it to me.
Sure.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Heck, Arthur Morgan's first decent bit of hunting after all these years.
Yeah. Well, we're on the run now. Everyone's got to do their bit to survive. Just make a good stew. Folk need it. It's been a tough few days.
Javier?
Hello, Arthur.
Up with you boys, because I thought you liked action. Couple of days on the lam, and you lot have all turned yellow. Apart from you, of course.
Shut up, Micah.
I ain't never seen so many long faces. I guess folks miss them. I fell. But when I fall, I don't want no fuss.
When you fall, there'll be a party.
A party? Probably.
Uh-huh.
That funny, huh? Sure. I don't feel like being laughed at by the likes of you two.
Stop it! Now! You fools punching each other when Como Driscoll's needing punching. Hard! You want to sit around waiting for him to come find us? All of you, we got work to do. Come on.
Are you sure about this, Dutch?
Yes.
Folks been through a lot recently. We hardly back on our feet yet.
And the last thing we need is to get bushwhacked by Como Driscoll. Let's go.
I know you hate him, Dutch.
He's here for us.
I doubt that.
No, you're just doubting me.
I would never doubt you, Dutch. You always said revenge is a luxury we can't afford.
This is the right call, Arthur. Take this. And this is about more than revenge for business long ago. They were talking about trains and detonators here. Cole always had good information. Come on.
And you think now is the right time to hit a train?
Now, you might fancy living on deer piss and rabbit shit. I'm getting too old for that life. Mr. Matthews, Mr. Smith, Mr. Pearson, would you please look after the place? There are O'Driscolls about. Yeah! Southwest, right, Arthur?
Yeah. He said follow the main trail southwest. They're camped near some lake.
Okay, let's go find these bastards before they find us and rob this score they're planning.
What's that? Tracks. Horses, quite a few of them.
far as I can tell, the only fools out here are us and them. They must be this way.
You good, Dutch?
Of course. Listen, I know you don't think much of my ideas recently, but this is the right move.
Okay. You know I got your back.
I learned a long time ago that you hit Colmo Driscoll. Wait for him, and people you love will die.
This feud between you and him needs to be put to rest, one way or another.
It will be.
Some things I can forgive, others I can't forget. What he did to Annabelle, I can't do neither.
You killed his brother, Dutch.
Yes, I did. And I hope the bastards will be reunited soon enough. That's how this'll end.
Damn right, boss.
See that smoke? Let's cut up here and take a look. They said it was near the lake, so we must be close. Gentlemen, this is it. Are we goddamn ready?
Ready, Dutch.
Good. Now, Mr. Morgan and I, we're gonna head up here a little, see if we can't get a sense of the layout of the camp. Mr. Williamson, Mr. Bell, you two take up a hidden position just outside the camp. Mr. Summers, Mr. Escuela, you two hold position here. Let's go. There they are. That's definitely them.
Home?
I think so.
Yeah, that's him.
Who's he talking to? He don't seem very happy.
No.
They leaving?
Seem to be. Should we go get them?
No. Colm can wait. Best to get some of them out of there. And much less fun to rob him and his score if he never finds out about it. Come on, let's get down there. Don't forget to grab that rifle from your horse. You boys be ready to pick them off from up there.
You got it, Dutch.
Good. Come on, let's go. Seems easiest to take the same path down as Bill and Micah. Like you said, revenge is a luxury we can't afford.
Yeah, just wasn't sure you agreed with me.
Arthur, have you completely lost faith in me? Our needs right now are supplies, equipment, and a way out of here. Everything else, including Colm, can wait.
Okay.
There's enough of those bastards down there to deal with as it is. Now come on. steep here. Careful.
Maybe I should take the lead on this. They're gonna be gunning for you.
They ain't got me yet.
No, but the way our luck's been running...
Hush. Let's just get down there first. Down through these trees, quick. Stay low. Come on, follow me. Get in cover, Arthur.
That feller smacked you up something.
So, what are we doing, Dutch? I can take this if you want.
Just make the call. You want to take the lead? Go.
Saw him with my own two eyes.
We have to move on this right now.
So why'd they let you go? I wouldn't have done.
Okay, fine. You make the move.
And you didn't tell him nothing.
Not a word.
All right. On.
Kill every last one of these bastards! Let's go!
About his men. All he cares about is numbers. If you can shoot a gun, and ride a horse, and kill without thought, you're in. Think how long some of you have been with me. I imagine Tom doesn't even know half the names of these fools. Heads up, boys! We got more coming in from the forest!
Action. bastard! Come on, man! Everyone with me!
Good work, boys. Now, let's tear this place apart. Bill, you go search that wagon there. Mike, search that building. Arthur, you take that building to the left. All right, man, quick. Find those detonators, explosives, anything you can. Let's go.
Here. This looks good. What do you think, Bill?
Well, looks fine. Smells good.
Come on.
Did we get everything?
Think so, boss. Found this on one of them.
Thank you.
This is perfect.
Oh, yeah. Interesting. This is something about the train they was gonna rob. A Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Mount back up. Let's keep moving. All right. Let's get out of here. Proud of you boys. All of you. Not a man down.
Good work, fellas.
Not bad for some starving down and outs. They can pummel us hard as they like. But we will always get back up and fight. That's who we are. Outlaws for life, fellas. Wait until we have John, Mac, Charles, and Sean back riding with us, and I believe, I know, they will all be back.
Well, you didn't get combed, but this hit'll hurt him a lot more than any bullet in the head.
Especially when we rob this train, too.
Yeah, I guess we'll see about that.
Oh, indeed we will.
You know, he'll come after us.
Oh, of course he will, just like all the rest. But we're gonna stay a step ahead of them. Make sure we always know where they are before they know where we are. We allowed ourselves to get a step behind in Blackwater. That won't happen again. All right, dig in, fellas. Let's make some ground! that fella? Wasn't he at the camp with Colm?
Leave him to me.
All right, we're heading back. Just bring him back alive. He could be useful.
Okay, you got it. Come on. Yeah.
Get away from me!
Oh, no, you don't.
Yeah.
You're coming with me.
Come on, I'm nobody, mister. You got me mixed up with someone else. Oh, God, no.
What's your name, boy?
I don't know.
You don't know your name?
It's Kieran.
Kieran what?
Duffy. Kieran Duffy.
Well, I ain't gonna lie to you. This is a real bad day for you, Kieran Duffy.
Where are you taking me?
Somewhere you ain't gonna like.
Why? What are you gonna do to me?
Something you ain't gonna like. So I'd advise you to save your breath for screaming.
No, please! Let me go. I'll disappear. I'll go to Mexico. Come on, mister. Please.
You better shut your mouth, you little shitter. I will shut it for you.
Please, I'll do anything. Oh, I think I'm gonna puke. I don't know nothing real about him, honest.
Are you trying to test me? Is that it? Because I will break every bone in your body.
I'm sorry. Okay?
Not one more goddamn word. Am I clear?
Okay.
That's two bones right there. Sack of shit. Let's introduce you to the boys.
Don't hurt me, please.
Oh, don't worry. They're real nice.
Huh. You found a little shit, did you?
Yeah. I got them.
Very good. Welcome to your new home. Hope you're real happy here.
You want me to make him talk?
Oh, no. Now all we'll get is lies. Uncle, Mr. Williamson, tie this maggot up someplace safe. We get him hungry first. I got a saying, my friend. We shoot fellas as need shooting, save fellas as need saving, and feed them as need feeding. We are gonna find out what you need. I can't believe it! An O'Driscoll in my camp!
No, I ain't an O'Driscoll, mister! I hate that fella!
Oh, whatever you say, son. Well done, Arthur.
I'm just sorry we missed out on Colm.
Oh, there's time enough for that. Now, I gotta figure out if we can hit that train.
Okay. It's been a bad few weeks, but Dutch,
being Dutch, he is busy making plans, and Dutch being Dutch, those plans involve robbery and dreams.
Well, I thought you was reading him his last rites. Now I see you're introducing him to your other passion.
I'll mind you to show me some respect, Mr. Morgan.
Mind away, Reverend. You still here, then?
I owe you.
Yeah. And you'll pay me. But for the moment, just rest.
Arthur! I think it's time for the train.
Want me to come?
Of course I do, but... look at you.
I was always ugly, Dutch. It's just a scratch.
Don't lie still, son.
Hello, Abigail.
Dutch?
Jackie.
The boy wanted to see you, John.
He's seen me now. Or what's left of me. What about you?
Guess I was hoping to see a corpse.
Bide your time. You'll see plenty of them.
You're a rotten man, John Marston.
He is an idiot, Abigail. We all know it. Now, railway men. Bill, now you ride ahead and set the charge at the water tower just before the tunnel.
Ain't a problem. Why are we doing this? Weather's breaking. We could leave. I thought we was lying low.
Yeah. Come on.
What do you want from me, Hosea?
I just don't want any more folks to die, Dutch.
We're living, Hosea. We're living. Look at me. We're living. Even you. But we need money. Everything we has in Blackwater. You fancy heading back there?
No. Listen, Dutch, I ain't trying to undermine you. I just want to stick to the plan, which was to lie low, then head back out west. Now, suddenly we're about to rob a train.
What choice have we got?
Leviticus Cornwall's no joke, Dutch.
Well, who is Leviticus Cornwall?
He's a big railway magnate, sugar dealer, oil man.
Well, how good for him. Sounds like he has more than enough to share.
Dutch!
Gentlemen, it is time to make something of ourselves. Get your horses ready. We have a train to rob. Everyone ready? All right, let's head out.
Despacio.
Okay, gentlemen, listen up, all of you. According to the information so kindly provided to us by the O'Driscolls, the train will be coming north from Big Valley. We're gonna pick it off after it crosses the border into the Grizzlies. There's a raised spot there that should give us good vantage. Charles, you'll keep lookout for any outriders. How's that hand, by the way?
I'll be fine.
Good. I'll take the driver and engineer, then run point. Lenny and Javier, you two take the front cars, deal with any guards. Arthur and Micah, you head straight for the back. That's what we're after. Mr. Cornwall's private car.
You and me, Morgan.
Great.
Have you got a problem with that?
Not if you keep your head for once.
You worry about yourself, huh?
Enough! After Bill blows the tracks, we're gonna need to move fast. Is everyone clear on what they're doing?
Yep.
Crystal.
Yes, boss.
Good. Now, come on. Let's ride. It's done fast. Now it's thawing before anyone gets up here after us. Oh, look at you boys. See? This is what I call a crew. Micah Bell, Charles Smith, Arthur Morgan,
Javier Escuela, and what about young Lenny here? Always the first man on his horse.
Just happy we're back at him, Dutch.
You sure you're ready for this, kid?
Of course I'm ready.
Just stay calm. Keep your eyes sharp. That goes for all of you. No mistakes. Not again.
So we do this, then we go back to Blackwater to collect.
How many times you gonna ask the same question, Micah?
That's a lot of damn money to leave sitting for too long.
It would be crazy to go back there now. The place will be swarming with Pinkertons.
We go back when I say we go back, and that's the end of it. Money's safe. You'll just have to trust me. And if the O'Driscolls are right, there'll be a stack of railroad bonds on this train. Good money, once we work out how to cash them. Now everyone, shut up and get your mind on the job at hand. Come on!
Behind you. Go.
There's the water tower. Hold up here on the ridge.
Whoa there.
Is Bill there?
Yeah.
You want to head down, see how he's getting on?
Okay.
Whoa! Whoa!
God damn it! Carl!
Why are you riding all over the place?
Slow up now. How you getting on?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You sure?
Of course.
Can I help a little?
All right. Go ahead and set up the detonator by those rocks over there.
Okay, sure.
Now just unspool the wire and then attach it to said detonator.
Okay, this is good.
All right. That should do it. You head back up to the others. I got it from here. Don't need you distracting me here, Morgan.
Mistakes.
What's going on? He says all fine.
We'll soon
everything
find
okay?
Out.
I think so. Okay, cover your faces. Train should be here any minute now. That includes you, Arthur? Gentlemen, it's time. Good luck, all of you. You all know what to do.
Here we go. Shit! No! What? God!
Oh, you have got to be kidding me!
Where did you find that moron?
Who said it was fine?
So it's my fault.
Come on!
You're pathetic. You know that?
Here we go!
got you. Now stop yelling.
Shit.
Oh,
shit.
Yeah, you're okay. Now, let's go slow this thing down.
Where's Javier?
He fell. The others will get him.
Come on, let's get to the front.
Come on, we need to stop this train.
There's another guard up ahead. You want me to take him?
Yes, let's get the money and go.
We got some fellas holed up in this last car.
Ah, shit.
What are you boys planning on doing in there? Listen to me. We don't want to kill any of you.
Any more of you.
I give you my word, but trust me, we will.
I work for Leviticus Corps.
Come on, boys.
We got our orders.
Okay, you asked for it.
We ain't Five, opening this door.
4, 3, 2, 1. Seems our friends have gone deaf. Wake them up a little.
You got no way in here.
That's enough.
Mr. Williamson, give Mr. Morgan and Mr. Smith some dynamite. You two boys go blow that door open.
Now, it don't matter too much to us, but you boys in there might want to take a step back.
Seems good enough. Now light the fuse.
Here we go.
Unless you got a death wish, I'd step back, fellas.
All right, come on. Just walk on out here. We don't want to kill you.
My oh
we just
my.
Want to rob your boss. Get on up there. Search that train.
Look at this place. It's like a palace.
Well, now I've seen everything. Oh, you two got the safe? I'll search the rest.
Oh, yes. Should be easy as cake. You're just gonna stand there, kid. Pour me some brandy, will ya? I'm parched.
Shut up. Me and Arthur did all the work.
Yeah, kid did good. Didn't see you rushing to jump on that train.
He's keen. I'll give you that. Okay, let's see if we can get this open.
This'll be over soon.
Come on. Come on. Get in there. Ah, there. See? That's how it's done. Shit. It's just a pile of papers.
Bonds?
I don't think so. Here, make yourself useful. At least we all know you can read.
Give me those.
Railroad contracts, invoices, blah, blah, blah. You got anything?
Not really. Sugar imports from the Spanish West Indies. A lot of sugar. Some fancy new boaties ordered from Europe.
I am not robbing another boat as long as I live. Have you checked all the drawers and cabinets? Yeah.
Come on! Let's hurry this along, boys! I think I got him.
Nice.
Well, thank God. Come on.
What did you find?
These bonds. They worth anything?
Oh, sure. Bearer bonds. I think we can probably sell these pretty easily. Well done. Now, would you get rid of all of this?
The train?
Yeah, get it out of here.
What about them?
What do you think?
I don't know.
It's up to you. Kill them, leave them here, take them with you on the train. Just make sure they don't send no folk after us.
Okay.
See you back at camp. When you get back, we'll be moving on. The rest of you, let's ride! Yeah.
Okay, get on the train, quick, all of you. Any bright ideas, I kill all three, so behave. Come on, move!
We won't tell a soul, I swear!
Go on!
for Lord's sake! Put that book away and go help! Oh, Mary Beth!
So, we getting out of this hellhole?
We're gonna try. Weather seems stable.
And we just robbed the Leviticus Cornwall train.
We got money in our pockets. The worst is behind us, gentlemen. So the question is, where now?
I know this country a little. I told you, we should set up camp in Horseshoe Overlook near Valentine. We'll be able to hide out there no problem, as long as we keep our noses clean.
Well, then let's go. Clean noses and everything else. Arthur, you're in that one. Bring Hosea. I know you two like to talk about the good old days and what's gone wrong with old Dutch. Get over here!
Yes, boss.
You two ride up ahead. Make sure there's no surprises. We've had enough of those.
Me? With the boy?
Just go.
Come on, kid. You can buy me a whiskey.
Let's take a look.
You all right back there?
Does everything look all right?
Well, what's going on?
I broke the goddamn wheel.
All right, let's get it fixed.
You need help?
I reckon we can handle it. All right, Charles, you and me hold the thing up while you try and put the wheel back on, Arthur.
You still strong enough to hold up a wagon?
Shut up.
I'm just saying.
Don't say less. Pick the wheel up. Nearly there. There.
See? You ain't so useless after all.
Not quite.
Think.
If they wanted trouble, we wouldn't have seen them.
Poor bastards. We really screwed them over down here. Come on, let's not push our luck.
What happened?
Well, get in. I'll tell you. Not too far now. Stay on this trail. We'll follow the river, then cut left inland. So, yes, the Indians in these parts got sold a very raw deal. This is the heartlands we're going to. Good farming and grazing country. They lost it all. Stolen clean away from them, it was, every blade of grass. Killed or herded up to the reservations in the middle of nowhere.
And how's that different from anywhere else?
Well,
Maybe it's not. I just heard some of the army out here was particularly unpleasant about it.
Unpleasant? How do you rob and kill people pleasantly?
We don't, in spite of Dutch's talk.
I fear I was perhaps trying to simplify something more complicated for the benefit of our blockheaded driver here.
Hey, don't blame it on me. Never forget, this here's a con man, Charles, born and bred. Just because it sounds fancy don't mean he knows a damn thing about what he's talking about. So, what happened to your tribe?
I don't even know if I have one. At least, not that I can remember. My father was a colored man. He told me he lived with our people for a while. A number of free men did, but when we were forced to move from our lands, the three of us fled. I was too young to really remember much. My whole life I've been on the run. A couple years later, some soldiers captured my mother. Took her somewhere. We never saw her again. We drifted around. He was a very sad man, and the drink had a mean hold on him. Around 13, I just took off on my own.
That was about the age we found young Arthur here. Maybe a little older. A wilder delinquent you never did see. But he learned fast.
Not as fast as Marston, apparently.
Wait, I don't understand. What's the problem between you two?
Arthur?
It's a long story. We still heading the right way?
That depends. Are we still heading west in search of fortune and repose in virgin forests as we plan? No. Are we heading in the correct direction on our desperate escape from the law eastwards down the mountains? Yes, I believe so.
You know this area?
A little. I've been through a couple of times. There's a livestock town not too far from here called Valentine. Cowboys, outlaws, working girls. Our kind of place.
The Driscolls?
Probably them too.
Pinkertons?
Let's hope not.
And this place we're going. Wait, but what's it called again?
Horseshoe Overlook.
It's a good place to lie low?
It'll do for now. And how low do you think Dutch is really going to lie? It's just, you know, maybe it's me who's changed, not him, but we kept telling him that ferry job didn't feel right. You and me had a real lead in Blackwater that could have worked out.
Maybe.
It just isn't like Dutch to lose his head like that.
Things go wrong sometimes. People die. It's the way it is. Always has been. Me, you, Dutch. We've all been in this line of work a long time. And we're still here, so I figure we must have got it right a hell of a lot more than we got it wrong. What are you working on there, anyway?
Just some yarrow and ginseng. Good for the health. Better than that stuff you buy in the store. Yeah, you can have all this. I'm at the point where I can do it with my eyes closed.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Yeah.
Follow the track for a bit.
Thanks.
Hey, slow up. I'll jump on. Okay, let's go.
Any trouble getting in here, Javier?
Nope. It went well. This is a good spot.
Excellent. I think this'll work for us, Arthur. For now, anyway. Here we are, gentlemen. Home sweet home.
You weren't wrong, Jose. This place is perfect.
I hope so.
Gentlemen, we have survived.
For now.
Now it is time to prosper.
Arthur and I were about to prosper in Blackwater. We were onto something big. Then Micah got you all excited about that ferry, and here we are.
We have all made mistakes over the years, Hosea. Every last one of us. But I kept us together. Kept us alive. Kept the nooses off our neck.
I guess I'm just worried. I ain't got that long, Dutch. I want folks safe before I go.
Me too.
And now we are stuck. East of the Grizzlies and out of money. And a long way from our dream of virgin land in the West.
I know, my brother. But we are safe. We make a bit of money here. Then we move again. Head out around them. Be west of Uncle Sam. In a few months, buy some land.
I hope so.
Would you just look around you? This world has its consolations.
Gentlemen, I'm going to head into the local town and, see if I can strike up a little business.
Of course, Herr Strauss. I prefer robbing banks to usury. Seems more dignified somehow. Now, everyone, put your tools down for a moment. Come on, gather around. Quickly now. I know that things have been tough, but we are safe now, and we are far too poor. So it is time for everyone to get to work.
Get to work, but stay out of trouble. Remember, we are itinerant workers.
Laid off when they shut down our factory to the north. Now get out there and see what you can find. Uncle, Reverend Swanson, no more passengers. It is time for everyone to earn their keep.
There is a town a little way down the track named Valentine. Livestock town, all mud and morons, if I remember right. That seems a decent place to start.
And, we need food. Real food. That means every day. One of you.
And remember, whatever it is that you find, the camp gets its slice. Now be sensible out there.
Now the girls have your tent ready, Mr. Morgan. Come with me. You two will be ready shortly. We put you over here.
I'm sure everything will be fine, Miss Grimshaw.
It should be. Most of your stuff from Blackwater got saved.
Everything apart from my money.
Oh, don't remind me.
Well, we can always make more money.
We're gonna have to. Miss Jackson, I've seen shit with more common sense than you. Do it properly.
East into some pretty enough country called the Heartlands. Ain't been this far east in many a year. Dutch seems a little better. His eyes are sparkling once more, and I can see he's thinking a little clearer. I think we all feel a little happier, in spite of Blackwater and that whole mess.
Arthur?
Jose?
Quite a day.
Let's hope so.
There's a bunch of the boys already in Valentine. Bill, Charles, and Javier. And Swanson found something down at the train station by the lake, apparently. And Strauss came back with that creepy little smile on his face. I'm sure there's a whole list of unfortunates he's forced money upon.
Thank you. And you?
I'm gonna read a book.
Is that food coming along, Mr. Pearson?
Got that look again, Dutch.
Okay there, Jose.
You
Have any luck out there?
Oh, a few bits and pieces. Robbed a drunk one at a fight.
Arthur never said he'd been robbed.
No, not Arthur. Also, a couple of morons in the lynch. So, I ran away, came back, robbed him.
Good lad.
How about you?
Ow! Oh, oh!
Careful not to work yourself to death there, Uncle.
I was thinking.
Yeah, does it pay well?
Oh, eventually.
So, while the rest of us are busy stealing, killing, lying, fighting to try to survive, you get to think all day.
Well, it's a strange world we live in, Arthur Morgan.
Hey, you want to head into town? See if we can find anything out?
Sure. I got some errands to run.
Great. Go check the horses are ready.
If you're going to take the old man into town, you can take us too?
Well, what you got planned?
Nothing. We'll find something for y'all two to do. We always do.
We're bored out of our minds. Been cooped up here for 2 weeks now. Karen's about ready to murder Grimshaw.
Well, can Miss Grimshaw spare you?
Can Miss Grimshaw spare you? What's happened to you, Arthur? 3 young, healthy women want you to take them a robin. You're worried about house chores. Let's go.
Fair enough. You got me. Come on in.
I can't believe we're going to see civilization. Feels like weeks since we did.
Yeah, Valentine.
Very embodiment of civilization.
The ladies are going to love it.
Okay, then. Let's go.
All right. Out through the trees here, then take a left.
Yeah.
Ladies, play us a song.
All right. I got a girl in Fairyville. Can't be screwed because she's too damn ill. So I don't go down there no more. There's a blue horse waiting outside her door. I had a girl in Valentine. Likes to drink that fancy wine. Blue and her hat was 2 feet tall. Cracking her pants right for it Twitter. All. Won't stay still. She kicks and streels and farts and hollers. Won't take less than $7. I got a girl in Fairy Lane.
I messed it up.
I got a girl across the lane. Hair down there like a horse's mane. I got a girl and she's got a thing. Fits my feet like a diamond ring. I got a girl in Valentine. Likes to drink that fancy wine. Bloom in her head is 2 feet tall. Cracking her pants pay for it all.
Look at that Koji. He's all over the place.
Is one of you gonna get that fella's horse?
Well, I got lumbago. It's very serious.
All right, I'll see what's going on. Lumbago, really? Easy there.
Yes!
Here. Here you go.
You're a gentleman, sir. A gentleman.
No, not really. I was just trying to impress the women.
Well, anyway, thank you.
You're turning into a regular old fairy godmother there, Arthur.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means you got a heart. A small one, perhaps, hidden deep inside, but a real one. And you haven't, your pulse of old lizard.
Lizards have hearts.
Well, Arthur, I'm proud of you.
To be honest, if you lot hadn't been here, I probably would have robbed him.
Well, you did.
That uncle.
Oh, very funny.
This looks like a decent little town.
Other people, finally.
Look at all that snow on the mountains.
Sure don't want to be back up there.
You think we should have asked Molly to come with us?
Oh, no. Miss O'Shea is far too high and mighty now for the likes of us, or to do any real work. She's a society lady now. Okay. Take a good look around, ladies. See what we got here.
Go left here, down the main street.
Fair's always on the right.
Sure you can pick up some bounties there, Arthur.
Heaven forbid you put your head on the line.
Yeah, well, that's a young man's game.
Ooh, yes! We can get up to some mischief here, all right.
Just remember, keep a low profile.
Will you remember that, though, Arthur?
Probably not.
Let's park up down the end there, near the stable.
You got a problem?
All right. Here we are, just like I said. A cultural center of civilization. Man at his finest.
Uncle, what are we doing?
Well, we're going to do what any self-respecting maniac does. Put the women to work.
With pleasure. We'll start at the saloon.
Okay, just stay out of trouble and don't get yourselves noticed.
Right, I need to get something from the stores.
Okay, well, we'll see you at the general store when you're done.
Come on, ladies. Imagine we're in Paris.
Come on.
Imagine Paris and Valentine.
So that's how you see yourself, is it? A maniac?
Well, in my youth, I used to be known as the one-shot kid.
Okay. I'm not gonna ask why.
You are a sad man, Arthur Morgan. But I know you love me.
Desperately. You're my favorite parasite. No, ringworm's my favorite parasite. You're my second favorite parasite.
Very funny.
I lied. Ringworm, then rats with the plague, then you.
Shut up. This is the place now. Come on.
Morning.
So, what do you need?
Well, a drop of whiskey for a start. Well, something to pass the time while we're waiting on the women.
Always thinking ahead, ain't you?
You're looking a bit tired there, Arthur. Why don't you pick up some coffee while we're here?
Let me know if you have any questions, fellas.
Okay, if you're done, I'll meet you outside. I won't be too long.
So, you're actually buying for once? Are you feeling all right?
See this? Young folk got no respect for their elders no more. What do you reckon? A lamb or a sausage?
Well, this is me.
Here's to your good health, my sir. It's a funny world, you know. This time in my career, I pictured myself being married to an heiress.
Gentlemen, I think I got something good.
What?
I snuck into this fancy house. Acted like a servant girl. Usually works. Someone was saying her sister was taking a trip from New York or someplace. Train full of rich tourists heading to Saint Denis and then cruising off to Brazil.
Okay.
A train laden with baggage and passing through a bit of deserted country at night as to get to the docks in time for the tides in some place called Scarlet Meadows.
Yeah, I know it. Yeah, it's right out near New Hanover. Right, it's real quiet out there.
Sounds good. Where's Tilly and Karen?
I think at the hotel. They were picking up some drunken fellas that they was gonna rob.
Why?
It seemed easy. They have been gone for quite a while.
I guess I'll go see if there's any trouble.
Oh, there's Tilly over there. That does not look ideal.
Excuse me.
Get your hands off me.
You thought I wouldn't find you, Tilly.
Huh? You can go kiss a damn snake for all I care. Get off me. Get off of me.
I've been looking too long. Get your hands off of her. Who are you?
A friend of mine.
Get the hell off of her, you son of a bitch.
Hey, take it easy. There's no problem here.
There will be if you don't get out of here right now.
You're making a big mistake, Tilly Jackson.
Just get lost.
I ain't doing this with you right now.
Go wait with Uncle and Mary Beth. They're across the street.
Okay. Thanks, Arthur.
What was that all about?
Just someone I used to know.
Uncle! Look after her. I'm gonna go see about Karen in the hotel.
Come on! Can I help you, sir?
I'm looking for a girl who came in here earlier with a drunk fella. Mid-20s, blonde. You'd remember her.
Yeah, they're in 2B upstairs. Are you, a friend of his?
A friend of hers.
No trouble now, please!
Friend of hers.
Get out of here, buddy. I paid.
Ain't paid to hit her, you goddamn animal. Come here!
Avoid me. What the hell are you doing here?
Trying to play him. Not very well.
You okay?
Fine.
You sure?
Yeah. Nothing to worry about. Just men. But stupid bastard. Stupid bastard was boasting about the bank.
The bank?
Sure, I know small town banks are usually a waste of time, but this is a livestock town. There's lots of cash sometimes.
Okay. Everything's okay up there? Keep investigating.
I will. After you. Thank you, Arthur. I don't much like being saved, but when I have to be.
I understand.
You okay?
Sure. He only punched me. Arthur punched him a lot harder.
All right, then.
Hey, who's that guy over there looking at us?
Weren't you in Blackwater a few weeks back?
Me? No, sir. Ain't from there.
Oh, you were. Well, I definitely saw you with a bunch of fellers.
Me? No. Impossible. Listen, buddy. Come here for a minute.
I saw you.
Come here.
Come on, get.
I don't like this. Me neither. Go get the girls home. I'm gonna go have a word with our friend.
Be careful, Arthur.
Just a word. Yeah.
Shit, no!
Hey, that's my horse!
Just borrowing it.
You stay away from me!
Get
here right now! That's far enough!
Why me? I didn't mean nothing by it. Honest! Come on! Yeah! Yeah! You have to help me!
Why are you telling lies about me?
No, no! I got it wrong, partner. I got it very wrong. Now please help me up.
I ain't never been in Blackwater.
Then why are you chasing me?
I've got an unfortunate face.
Yes, yes, me too. Now please pull me up. Please. Please.
All right, come on. You okay, partner?
No. No, I am not. I'm a mess.
Well, you ain't dead.
There is that. Jimmy Brooks.
I think it's best for both of us if we pretend this never happened.
Well, I agree. You saved my life. You're a good man, and I, here. You want a pen? It's one of them steel ones.
Oh. That's very kind of you. But I'm not a good man, Jimmy Brooks. Not usually. You see, I was in Blackwater. I kill people. And maybe I should have killed you. Should I have killed you, Jimmy Brooks?
Me? I never saw you. Not now, not never. I think we have an understanding.
Of course we do. Jimmy Brooks. I will remember that. I've got a good memory.
I haven't. I haven't. Not one lick. Not one cent in this here old mind. Come on. Come on. You have a nice day now, sir.
Parker?
Hey! My horse!
Am I glad to see you?
Here's your horse back, friend.
Oh, you really were just borrowing it.
Appreciate it.
Oh, hello.
Welcome back.
Howdy, partner.
New patron. Welcome. Well, it's really the catalog you want to look at. It's got everything in here.
Now, let me just look in here.
Uh-huh. It's a nice piece and all, but I'd personally add some rifling. Take it or leave it.
Smile on your face, guaranteed.
I got some nice carved stocks here. I think you should take one.
You'll love it.
You thought about upgrading the stock? I got some nice ones.
Got what I need.
Bet that piece could use a personal touch now that you've had it for some time.
You know what? Bet you could use some rifling on this thing.
That's more like it.
Smart addition. Dangerous.
Yeah, that's what they said.
If it weren't for all the bounties running around New Hanover, I'd be out of business. Just remembered I put my pistol down as a bid in poker the other night. I can't recall who won that, though. Damn. All the trouble in Valentine late, and people are starting to...
So long.
How do you? Mister?
Give a fella a nickel.
Every time.
Stranger.
We got a wild one here. Hey, all right, there we go. Oh, Arthur, come here. Come over here. I want you to meet our friends.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, ain't you just a tough-as-teak mountain man?
Oh, you be quiet, Anastasia. Anyone can tell this one is a pussy cat.
Exactly. Yes, he's a pussy cat. Ain't that so, Arthur?
Whatever you say. How much you cost, anyway?
Well, ain't that a nice way to talk to a lady?
Oh, I didn't know I was talking to a lady.
Excuse me.
Well, I must say, you got a fine way with the women, amigo.
Yeah, regular dandy and a charmer. Where's Bill?
Oh, man, I dread to think about it. Hey! There he is.
Watch where you're going.
Take it easy,
you about
pal.
To kiss that guy
Take
or punch
easy,
him?
Huh?
Oh, and we have our answer!
Come here, you! Let's just shoot these bastards!
Come on, bring it down! You picked the wrong town!
Stop that!
I'm out of fight! I'll beat this
sir.
I'll make you go away!
Yeah, I get like I
kill you, you stupid bitch.
Yeah, buddy.
That's it! We can deal with these fellas. Go get Javier!
Hey! Tough guy!
You want some too, huh?
Come on, pretty boy.
Pretty boy? You're kidding me. Pretty boy?
Try that again. Come on, let's see it.
You okay there, my friend?
Yeah, I got this son of a bitch.
Okay. Yeah.
You're even slower than you look. Come on. I ain't even started.
Stop. Come, sir. You won the fight already. Surely that's enough.
What business is it of yours?
No business. No business, sir. But please, I beg you.
Making new friends again, I see, Arthur.
Look who we found sniffing about.
Josiah Trelawney.
The very same.
Well, I thought you'd gone to New York.
And miss all this glamour. You must be joking.
How are you?
Well, quite well indeed. I went to Blackwater looking for you gentlemen. You're not very popular there, it seems. Ah! Javier and Charles. I've missed you. And Bill, looking as well as can be. Gentlemen, always a pleasure.
You're right. We ain't too popular in Blackwater.
We left a lot of money there.
And young Sean, it seems.
Sean, you found him?
Yes, I have. He's being held by some bounty hunters, trying to see how much money the government will pay them. I know he's in Blackwater, but there's talk of them moving.
Well, if we step foot in Blackwater, well, then we're dead men for sure.
There'll be Pinkertons all over the place, but if he's alive, we gotta try.
Yeah, of course.
It's you they want, Dutch.
Always is. Charles, go find out what you can, carefully. Josiah, take Javier. Arthur, go get yourself cleaned up. Join them when you're ready.
Well, what about me?
Well, exactly. What about you?
What does that mean?
Oh, Bill, come on.
Let's move. Oh, hell no.
No, not me.
Yeah.
Feels like we're back on track, more or less. Yep, money and food. Now everyone needs to keep it coming.
It's enough to turn a good, honest fella to drink. Being a bad, dishonest fella, it's gonna send me to drink twice as fast. I just can't cope. Really. I can't.
Arthur.
Jose?
You want to go hunting?
What are you hunting? An elephant?
I wish. No. I saw a huge bear. One of the biggest I ever saw. I reckon nearly 1,000 pounds.
My God. But you need me to come with you.
Of course. Let's go.
Where are we heading exactly?
Up near the Dakota River. Might take a day or two.
I could do with a break from this place.
Oh, me too. It's been a rough couple of weeks. You need anything?
I don't think so. I got all I need.
Let's go then. So you still ain't replaced Boadicea?
Nah, I miss her. She was quite a horse. This one's okay, but ain't no Boadicea.
I've been meaning to offload this big Shire horse for a while now. Unruly bastard.
Where'd you get him?
Some big loudmouth bastard tried to rob me. Was out riding, so I... Well, you know how it is.
I see.
Let's take him to Valentine. It's on the way, sort of. There's a decent dealer there. We'll unload him. You could buy yourself a new horse. Put your saddle on them. Let's get going.
Okay. But I do kind of like this horse.
There's nothing wrong with two horses. And the stables always have the best ones.
Well, I guess you're right.
This is going to be fun, Arthur.
You won't throw me?
No, he's an angel. If I'm near him.
Nasty little look in his eyes.
Oh, don't be rude about this magnificent creature.
Easy, big fella.
All right, let's head into town. No bar fights, please. I heard about that.
I'll do my best.
We're heading out. Might be gone a couple of days. They got a good range of horse tack at the Valentine Stables. Some beautiful saddles. I used to have a real nice one.
Yeah, what happened to that?
Got stolen outside that saloon in Deer Creek.
Ah, I remember now. Just about. That turned into a long day.
Yes. Remember? Mac went crazy. Threatened to kill the whole town. And Davey was passed out so cold we left him there. Came back in the next day and he woke up, started right back drinking again.
I'll miss those boys.
Jenny, too. She had some spark, that girl.
It must be pretty hard on Lenny. You could tell he was sweet on her.
Well, Lenny and Jenny could never have worked. That's like Arthur and Martha, or Bill and Phil.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Does feel a bit like our luck died with them, too.
Nonsense. We'll be all right. Just need some money to get back on our feet.
I hope so. You found a way to offload those Cornwall bonds yet?
Not yet. They're still very hot. Need to be done right. I have a couple of leads I'm looking into. Don't let that big bastard get the better of you there, Arthur.
He's all right.
Stables are just up ahead. All right. Go sell that big brute and buy yourself a horse.
Okay.
I'm going off to the general store. Get a few things to lure that bear out with. Meet you back here in a bit.
Hey, how can I help you?
I'm in the market for a new horse. Something strong and fast.
Yeah, well, you're in the right place. I got some beauties in at the moment. Yeah. And what about this one here? Yeah, you looking to sell?
I show you.
You got papers?
No. No papers.
Well, of course, that's going to affect what I can pay. But your luck's in. I got a fella who's been looking for a decent workhorse like this for a while. He'll pay a good price. Otherwise, I can always stable him here for you. Here, take a look. Partner, you got yourself a deal and a fine new horse.
I hope so.
Well, I don't sell anything other than good animals. You have my word on that. All right, let's see. Here are your papers. And on me, a new grooming brush and some treats.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. All right, you. You treat this fella well. I know he's gonna look after you just fine.
Looks like a nice animal you got there. You happy?
Guess we'll see. Okay, boy. Let's go.
All right, let's get going. We got quite a ride ahead of us.
Lead the way. So, what's this lake we're heading for?
It's called O'Cray's Run, up in the mountains east of Cumberland Falls. I just hope I can remember how to get there.
Back into the mountains? I sure didn't figure on that.
But this time, we're doing the chasing. Hold! So how are things with you and John?
Fine.
Ain't it about time you let it go now?
It was a year, Hosea. He ditched us for a goddamn year.
I've spoken to him many times. He knows he did wrong. He just wants to put it behind him.
I'm sure he does. Running off on that kid is one thing, but there's code. He knows that. He ain't Trelawney. Dutch and you pretty much raised
him. I know. But it's done. Has been for a while now.
Nobody else would have been welcomed back that easy after that long. And you know it.
Maybe. But please don't you put that to the test.
I never would.
Okay, I think we need to head right up here. Yes, I remember this place. Moonstone Pond. We're going the right way. We made it. Let's loop around the other side.
Where do you think Mike and Lenny got to? Susan sent them out scouting, but I figure they'd be back by now.
I have no idea. I hope they weren't picked up.
Why she sent Mike, I don't know.
He's effective in his own way. Lenny's got a good head on his shoulders.
Well, shouldn't have taken him this long.
No, but no point thinking the worst. Look there. Rabbits. Maybe we should catch one to cook.
Sure. Try and shoot one.
You don't want to... use anything too powerful on a small animal like that. Just ruin the meat. Best thing's a bow or a .22 caliber varmint rifle.
I have hunted rabbits before, you know.
Yes, and obliterated them with a shotgun, if I remember right.
Okay.
Good job. All right. It's getting late. Reckon we should camp here.
Sure.
Fallon, you get us set up.
I'm famished.
Cook that rabbit, then. They're delicious on an open fire like this.
Fine by me. You want some of this?
No, I'm fine. I don't like eating this late.
Okay. After all that.
All right. Well, we better get some rest. I want to be up at first light to find this monster.
He better be worth all this drama.
Morning, Arthur. You ready?
Well, give me a minute.
Coffee?
Sure.
There you go.
So, what's your plan?
Well, we'll see if we can track him, but we might need to lay bait to draw him out. Bears like fish, obviously, but they also have a sweet tooth. A lot of fellas bait, then shoot from the trees, but I prefer to hunt on the ground. More dangerous, but we'll have a much better chance of getting a good shot in. And if he bolts, we can start right off after him. Can you mix up this bait for me while I finish packing this up? Fish, berries. I'll tie it up in that rag when you're done.
I hope you know what you're talking about.
I grew up in the mountains, Arthur. I was virtually weaned on bear meat. Just mix it together. It's not too hard.
Okay, I think I got this done.
Good. Pack up and we'll get going. Come on, grab your stuff and let's go. Okay, let's go. We'll try our luck down by the water. That's where I saw him last.
Okay.
How's that horse treating you?
So far, so good.
You know, I was in this area with Bessie years ago.
Really? I didn't know that. I imagine you still miss her.
Every day.
Did you two ever think about getting out of the light?
We did briefly. You don't remember? Guess you were still young. Didn't last long. I drifted back into it. She understood. She knew what I was.
I remember you not being around for a while, but well, things were looser back then.
Truth is, there's never really any getting out. And staying in, it's hard. You know that. But Bessie and I made it work. Why? You thinking about getting out?
Me? No, of course not.
Listen, if Dutch's grand plans work, and we can make enough money to go someplace new, really new, maybe we can all have a new start. Anyway, for now, let's try and chase ourselves a bear, shall we? Let's look by the water here, see if he's been fishing again recently. Easy. Look for tracks, dung, bones. Any sign of him.
Well, there's some paw marks here, Hosea. They sure look big enough.
Good. Let's hope it's him. Can you tell which way he went?
This way. Tracks go into those trees.
What is it? Half-eaten fish here. Must have been left by our friend, I reckon.
Come on, see if there's anything else. Just here. There's shit here. Watch your step.
Looks real fresh. Reckon he's gotta be close.
Let's keep going.
Damn it. Looks like the trail ends here.
We lost him?
For now. A little optimism, Arthur.
Well, what do you think?
I think we split up in each look.
Either that or we could place bait here.
That could work. Which do you think?
Let's bait here.
Fine by me. Let's leave the bag over there.
By those boulders up ahead, looks like a good spot for it. Now we wait.
A 1,000 pounds, you say?
More or less. Big scar down his face. Hey, did that bait look okay to you?
I think so. You're the expert.
Ready with your gun there?
I'm good. You okay? I seem nervous.
So do you. I'm fine. Let's just take a look at that bait.
Sure.
Come on.
We only just said it, Jose.
I know, but we need to do this right. Give me a hand here. Got your knife? Easy. No, it's too close. Is he gone? Over here, Arthur.
You're fine, old man.
Of course I'm fine. It's nothing. Nothing at all.
Thank you, I think. That was fun.
You know what, Arthur Morgan? I'm a little old and beaten up to be after the biggest game. You can have this.
What is it?
It's a map. A man in a bar gave it to me. Well, I stole it from him, but that's another story. He said it told him where to find some real big animals.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure. You saved my life, Arthur. I think I'm going back to camp to lick my wounds. You coming, or you gonna track that monster? Well?
I'm gonna stick around here for a while.
I'll see you back at camp. Yeah!
Here we are. Don't seem close. Must be near. Come on, boy.
road!
Hello, sir. First time here, I think. Let's have a look. Boy, the things I can make with this. Damn it, that's...
Damn it. Back here right now. You stop right now or you're dead. Stop, you'll be real sorry. Nothing for you to defend yourself. Straight out of my way.
Hi. instant!
Penny for the blind. Penny for the blind. Penny for the blind. Penny for the blind.
Help a blind man.
Okay, here you are.
Your father is seduced by the one with the forked tongue. It's no use hoping.
Well, okay then. Thank you, I guess.
Are you still here?
Yeah.
What are you waiting for? I can't tell you what you want to hear.
Yeah.
Yes, I...
Hi.
I'll be tending to you shortly. Ready for a clean slate?
Hello. How can I help?
See you later.
Hello.
Something from me?
Shit!
Well, looky here. Maybe this is our man.
You a bounty hunter, mister?
Maybe. It depends.
Well, I'm guessing you ain't here to pass the day, turn yourself in, or discuss the finer points of county law. Then I don't need to know much more than that until I got a reason to.
All right.
You smell that? This here's a livestock town, mister. Attracts delinquents and reprobates like flies. Now, I'm not a feller to pass a quick judgment, but I've been around long enough to know you don't hire a saint to catch a sinner. You bring me what I need, and I'll pay you well, and I won't ask no questions.
So, what is it you need?
Why don't you have a look at that poster on the wall over there?
He's a low-down huckster. He's been poisoning folks with his miracle cure from here to Annsburg. Killed more than Landon Ricketts without even pulling a trigger. Gets some kind of sick satisfaction out of it.
Feller over at the saloon says he thought he saw him by the gorge straight north of here. You think you can bring him in? The money's good. I need him alive, though. I want to make sure the women he witted get compensated before he swings.
I'll see what I can do.
Well, good luck to you.
And we need him alive. That's an important point.
Alive, I got it. Idiot. Here. Are you Benedict Albright?
Oh, sir?
Huh. Kind of look like him. And I was told he'd be up here. No,
not me, sir.
It's because I want to buy some medicine.
And I heard good things. I'll pay in gold if you could help me find him. It's just my mother's real sick. Oh, well, if that's the case, if it's for a sick woman, I'd be happy to help. I'm a healer, you know, a medical man. Finest medicine in the state. What? Game's over, mister. Put your hands up. I'm taking you in.
Taking me in? What for?
Apparently that stuff you're pushing is killing folk. And there's a price on your head. I don't know. It ain't my business.
Come on, partner. That's crap. I'm a healer. I got an aura. I speak to spirits. I'm a scientist. Folks get real angry for no good reason. This is a mistake.
Keep your hands up, buddy. They only want you for questioning.
I have to insist that this is a mistake.
Don't be a fool. Hold on.
I'm slipping. Shit. Wait. Oh, you saved me.
Now, come on, buddy. Let's make this easy.
What, you're taking me in?
It's just for questioning.
Oh, hey, you saved my life.
Ain't we had enough drama?
I'd be better off jumping.
They expressly told me not to kill you.
Oh, this is about you.
Don't jump.
Or what? You can't shoot me, huh?
Please.
I'll take my chance.
Come in.
Bye, friend.
Really do not like you. Okay, then.
Easy now.
Sir, I think I must be suffering from exposure.
Suffer a little longer.
I seem to keep blacking out.
You do seem to keep blacking out.
I mind my own affairs, and that's all.
Oh, my lord. I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Mrs. Calthorpe was just leaving.
Sure. Where you want him?
In the cell in the back.
There's been some terrible mistake. I never did it. Any of it.
I thought I told you to shut up, partner.
But I told
you. But nothing. Shut up. And good luck. It's been real fun.
You ain't much of a man. If you ask folks for forgiveness, you remember this, partner.
I've already forgotten. Now, sir, how much was you offering?
$50. Here.
Thank you. Madam.
Please, remember what I told you.
Hello.
How does you?
Oh, wait. You're that fellow who had to fight with Tommy outside of Smithfield's?
Yep.
People are still talking about that fight.
I ain't.
Fair enough. Neither's Tommy. Anyway, how can I help you today?
Thank you.
Good to see you. What can I do for you? Good. Ain't no trace of rust on that as far as I can see. I'd just like to give this a personal touch with some engraving. How are you doing? Things could be better. Hey, if it weren't for the bad, we wouldn't know when it was good. Any information about anything, anything at all, you can give me a shout.
Thanks, mister.
Now, my partner's feeling like about time we went on a tear. Ran across a passel of locals the other day.
Back in 76.
Just a lot of bunk, Plato. It's just a lot of bunk.
It's not bunk, Mr. Calloway, sir.
Who's your friend there?
Put that in your fucking book, Plato.
This is Jim Boy Calloway. The Jim Boy Calloway.
Who?
The gunslinger. Fastest left-handed draw that ever drew breath. He once killed 14 men in a fight at Lucy Hollow.
What are you waiting for?
How do you mean?
Well, I reckon right now, kill him yourself.
I don't want to kill him. I want to deify him. He's a god. I'm trying to write his biography.
How's that going?
I think I prefer the duel. Either I'd kill him and be able to be Baltimore's finest ever gunslinger, or he'd kill me and I could be set free from ever having to speak to him again.
Well, you're starting to understand something very important.
What's that?
The joys of gunslinging. It's win-win, freedom or glory.
That's brilliant. I'm gonna write that down, if I may.
Be my guest.
What's your name?
I don't have a name.
But you are a gunslinger.
Not really. I mean, folks who need shooting, I try and shoot in the back. All that other stuff, it's, well, bunk.
But you fought duels.
Once upon a time, I may have.
And you ain't interested in fame?
I don't think so.
Strange. But you like fortune.
I need money, sure.
Okay, then forgive me, mister, if I seem a little desperate. I am a little desperate. This book, I've got to make a thing of it, and, well, there's a whole list of gunfighters. Legends, every last one. Emmett Granger. Flacco Hernandez. Billy Midnight. Black Bell.
Never heard of them.
Maybe you can go and speak to them. Ask them about Calloway. Any of them get uppity, shoot him. I can't believe I just said that, but...
You want me to go and find some sad, deluded fools like him, ask if he was the greatest, and then if they get uppity, shoot him?
Does sound a lot worse than it did in my head.
How much you paying?
Well, a lot. Half the proceeds of the book, if you help me get it written.
I'll see what I can do.
Oh, get photos.
Okay.
And there are notes on the back of those portraits that should lead you to him.
I'll see what I can find out.
I imagine we'll be stuck here upon your return. Here or some other flop house.
Thank you.
Huh?
Get! Let me get through.
Vindicus, Cornwalls, train robbers, still at large.
Well, it just heard we all got to work
ahead. There, boy. Need a hand with your horse? Shit. Easy, boy. It's okay, boy. Yep. Easy.
Please, I can't feel my leg anymore. You have to get this trap off of me, please. Keep pulling. I can feel it getting looser. Oh, God. Oh, you did it. I gotta get some scrap or something here. Oh, Mr. Uke, I thought I was gonna be... Oh, go! Oh, I thought I was gonna be a goner. Oh, you can take whatever you want from my pack for saving me. Oh.
Here, this'll help with the pain at least.
Yes.
Good boy.
You there?
Oh, hello?
You a bounty hunter?
Well, not right now, I ain't. You Black Bell? I'd like to talk to you about your Wild West days.
I don't care much for reminiscing. You got any friends as bounty hunters?
None that spring to mind.
Well, then you done led them boys here and you none the wiser.
Ah, those bounty hunters.
Knew my luck had run out sooner.
Well, get inside. I'll tell them you're gone.
Oh, no. I ain't hiding from them scalp hunters. Not running from them, neither. And fighting? Yeah, if it's just me against them, that'd be a waste of time and nitroglycerin.
Well, let me know what I can do.
You want that Wild West story, don't you?
Yes, I do.
All right. Get up here, quick. Now, when I give you the word, hit that. Whole place is wired.
Black Bell, I got a contract here for your life or your liberty. We'd sooner it be liberty.
That's mighty reasonable, mister. Come here, let me take a look at it. Come on. Oh, come on. Stop just there. Now, set it off.
Them scalp hunters off your back.
For now.
For now. So, you gonna tell me about your Wild West days, running with Jim Boy Calloway?
Little Boy Calloway? The only running he did was away from a fight. And that's about the end of it.
Well, a man's apparently a famous gunslinger.
Yeah, so they say. But don't get what's famous confused with what's true. The ones of us that lived that life, we was too busy being scared for our scalp to talk to no newspaper writers or dime novel men.
Well, what were they like then? Those days they all talk about.
Same as now, I guess. Only longer ago.
All right. I'm gonna need your picture, too, if it ain't a trouble.
No, sir. No trouble at all. Can't be worse than those awful drawings on the wanted posters.
Hell, great. Look, you stand over there and let me get this thing ready.
Ready? How do you want me? Like this?
Okay, I got it.
Then I guess they'll be on my way.
There. Well, thank you, Mrs. Bell. You gonna be all right?
Oh, been running for 20 years. Suppose I'll be running till I drop. Just the way it is.
Yep. Good luck.
you're in this state for the federal government, you're an enemy of
the state. Stay back!
You know why you're here. Don't you?
Thank you, stranger. These raiders are insane.
First time in the Bastille, mister?
Morning, friend.
Bonjour.
Get off of me.
I had a fella come in here the other
day. Here we go.
Hair slicked back, big gold watch in his pocket. Said he made his money out in Rhodes, and now he's come here to take over. Oh, what do you have?
Don't mind me. Can I get something to eat?
I can already tell you how to break out.
It is so rare nowadays to meet a beautiful woman.
Bien, bonjour, monsieur.
Good day, dear.
I believe I saw men with pistols at the club last night. Terrifying. What is this world we're living in?
The Guyver boy asked Sally to marry him. Girl said no. Smart girl, Sally.
I need a bath. That's okay. Can you organize?
I'll have the girls make it for you. Just
bonjour, Sherry.
Got in the grain last night.
Happened before. Maybe.
Hey there.
You all on your lunch?
Une délicieuse surprise.
One of my regulars left the bill.
Do you want to have a good time?
No, I don't think so.
It's fine. Some men are intimidated.
Need someone to take over in there?
Nah, I'm all right, thanks.
All right, you go ahead. What have we here?
Bonjour, monsieur.
This place.
Mister.
Hello, sir.
Uncharacteristic for the season. Monsieur.
Thank you. Can anybody show me some kindness?
Mais bonjour.
Can I get a ride?
So where are you going? Sure thing. Flag me down if you change your mind.
How do you do?
And learn how you can save the white race.
Help me! Help me, please!
I want you to ask yourself, do I consider myself pure? And then I want you to ask yourself, what is the most disgusting, revolting, vulgar, and depressing thing in all creation? Mingling. Co-mingling. Nature. Nature likes purity. Nature does not like co-mingling. Nature likes a family tree, not a family bush. And this being America, and us being nature's paradise on Earth, we must push for purity. I want you, I need you, to be pure.
You talk a heap of shit, my friend.
You, sir, do you want a pamphlet?
Okay.
Read it. It's really interesting stuff. I explain, using real science, why we whites are under attack, and what we must do to fight back.
Under attack?
Yes, under attack. People aren't the same, sir. I mean, white people are the same. And all the other races are trying to kill us. I don't want to die, sir.
I got friends who's Mexican, friends who's Indian, known blacks, Irish, Italians, good and bad and all. I've known good white people and bad white people. And above all, dumb white people.
You, sir, are a real fool. How can you possibly believe in equality? I've never heard such nonsense in all my natural-born days.
This man believes people are equal. Speak for yourself, sir. Speak for yourself.
I'm sorry. You just call me a fool?
A fool! A fool! A fool!
Come here! Come at me then!
You piece of shit. You had your chance.
Oh, no.
Auxilio!
Hello.
How
can I help you?
I'll have, whatever you like.
Y'all in here, joint?
Has gone too far.
While we out there fighting?
Hey, now, settle down, fellas.
Don't reckon I've seen you in here before. You new to town? Well, Rhodes ain't what it used to be. Not for some time now. Ain't sure if you heard of the Gray family already. They own this damn saloon. They own the damn law. Hell, they own pretty much most of this town now. And it ain't the better for it, in my opinion. But a drink's a drink. Right, my friend? Good luck to you.
Madam?
Hello.
What do you boys need?
Hair, clean glasses, and some damn respect.
Bets are now closed. Here we go.
Howdy. Hello, mister.
Hello there.
Out of the damn way!
Well, hello.
Hey, mister, will you give me some money?
I was told. Idiot. Yep. Now.
zombie twisted my ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there?
Sure. Yeah. Easy.
Think you might have got twisted around. Glad I ran into you. Huh. I raised that horse, you know. Raised it since it was just a foal.
Losing a horse is hard. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, that horse did right by me. Better than my husband, truth be told. That fool. Always complaining. But does he do something about it? Man barely lifts his hand to wave the flies away. Aside from to lift a drink, of course. Marriage, for me, has been nothing but trouble. But Biscuit, he was a fine animal. Loyal, smart, brave. Didn't take no guff, not from no one. Had one of them mountain boys pull a gun on me once. I was riding up near the Dakota and had stopped by a nice warm patch. Must have dozed off, but I wake up and find some nasty piece of work pointing a rusty shotgun straight at me. Well, he gets wheezing on and I must have made some sort of noise, because the next thing I know, Biscuit had nipped his ear clean off. Kicked his hide, too, as he was hollering away. Didn't think a man could run so fast.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, had a good laugh on that one. I tell the husband, what does he do? Should have never gone over there, honey, he says. Gee, thanks.
So, you live at Emerald Ranch, then?
For the time being. I was looking for work. They was looking for some help with the gardens. If I waited any longer for my husband to put food on the table, I'd have died of starvation. I'll be moving on soon, though. Emerald Ranch, well, it's a strange place.
How so?
The owner's a mean bastard. Strange, too. Delights in bullying folk. There's a daughter, but she never leaves the house. You can see her in the window sometimes. When I asked about her, everybody told me to leave it alone. Found an old saloon there, all shut down now, but I went in to have a look, and there's bullet holes, old blood stains. Something definitely happened there, but I couldn't figure it. Just an uncomfortable feeling to the place. Yep. Either way, it's time I left, especially now I lost that poor horse. I'll collect my belongings and be on my way. Oh, we're getting close now. Here we go. This is great. This was kind of you, mister. Please, take this as my way of thanking you. Appreciate it. What a lousy day.
Look out!
be wandering around here, friend. Not a thing happens around here without an O'Driscoll saying. Oh.
Okay, then. God has finally deserted you. What you talking about?
I took your advice, sir. I have removed myself from Morpheus's embrace. No more shall I sink, sir. I am free. I am free.
You don't seem free, friend. You seem drunk.
Sit down, Reverend. We ain't finished.
You ain't finished. Look at him. He's finished.
None of us forced liquor down his throat. Friend, I just want him to play.
Now, firstly, we ain't friends. Don't make no mistake on that subject. Now, secondly, he can't hardly see, let alone reason. Now, reasoning ain't never been one of my strong points neither, but seeing I do just fine. You want to step outside or deal with business here?
I just want him to finish the game.
Why can't we all just get along? These are good men, Arthur. They're children of God. They are children of God.
Oh. How's about you playing his place, huh? That seems fair.
Fair?
Sure. You want a game?
Sure. I'll play a few hands.
Well, sit yourself down then. I'm Luther. This is Marvin.
Fortunate for you both for being gentlemen about this.
Same goes for you.
So, you two know each other anyway. Don't seem like the likeliest of friends, if you don't mind me saying.
We go a long way back.
And now you're his chaperone?
I guess it's something like that. Can we play?
He can't be no real clergyman. He committed about 5 cardinal sins just in that chair you're sitting in.
I think he used to be. He's drifted a little in recent years. Life is a challenge to all of us.
Can you imagine him at the pulpit? If he could stand up.
On the 4th day, he turned water into whiskey, and I don't remember much after that.
Look at his face. He's bluffing.
He's a decent fella going through a bad time. Disrespect him again, and you'll find yourself in a bad time, too.
All right, all right. Just trying to have a little fun here. It is a game, after all, mister.
Here, just a little.
Is that it?
Sometime before we all grow old would be nice.
I reckon I'll go all in.
Now you're talking my language.
There.
Pile of crap.
Not looking good.
Come on! Damn it!
Come on! Let's go.
I'll give you that one.
Not just a little wager.
Call.
Let's start this low for now.
Nah.
There we go.
Okay, then.
Now, don't get too worried.
I ain't buying that. All right, what do we got?
Here.
You're looking worried, my friend.
Well, gentlemen, time to move along.
Aw, hell. You're one lucky son of a bitch, you know that?
Oh, I'm surely a son of a bitch, but lucky? I ain't so sure. Come on, you. Let's move along. Where is he?
Who?
The Reverend. Where'd he go?
I don't know.
Shit. Excuse me, gentlemen. Reverend! Reverend Swanson! Where'd you go? Off him.
You'll keep. You stay out of it.
Get your hands off him now, you son of a bitch.
You better stop right there.
Stay away from me.
Stop, you son of a bitch. You better stop right now. I said stop, damn it.
Okay.
Tell anyone what you saw back there. You're a dead man. You understand me?
Yep.
I seen your face. So don't make me come looking for you.
It's the last thing I needed.
Now what? Where's Reverend?
This place and was stay.
Get your foot out of here. Twist your leg, you drunken bastard. Got it. Come on.
What the hell is wrong with you? Throwing me off a bridge like
there
that?
There was a goddamn train, you crazy bastard!
Have I been bad again, Mr. Morgan? I'm sorry. I wish I was different.
Let's get you home.
Home? Yeah, that's a wonderful idea. I could have tea with Margaret.
Margaret? Who's Margaret?
But...
So sleepy. Kippers, please.
Yeah.
Diamonds.
Yeah.
wondering when he'd show up.
You better sleep your way to salvation, my friend.
What happened?
Just the usual.
Poor bastard.
Exactly.
Well, thank you, Mr. Morgan. I'll keep an eye on him.
He was lucky this time. Real lucky.
Mr. Morgan. Getting real low on meat here.
Sure, might as well make some money off it. It all counts, Pearson.
Good job, Mr. Morgan.